It's been from 20 new clients. I had something happen the other day while I was playing squash. It hit me like a ton of bricks. And I'm going to share it with you, and it's directly affecting how successful you can be or how you sabotage your life. And I'm going to tell you what happened. I go and play squash every Wednesday morning with a guy. In the morning we play, and it's best of seven. What that means is the first guy to win four games wins the series for the day. Now, I was up 3-0. He hadn't won a game. And I then started feeling, on the fourth game, almost subconsciously, a little bit bad for the guy that hadn't won the game. Not even one game. And I started making bad shots. I started pulling back. I wasn't fighting for that win anymore. I was just pulling back. And I go, why am I doing this? And I started asking myself, how is this affecting my life today? When I get successful, am I sabotaging or pulling back because I feel bad for the guy that's not winning? And then it led me to think that, hey, we are really good at losing. What I mean by that is it's crazy how, like, when you have no money, somehow we can make it. We can get through that tough time. And I thought about how good we are at budgeting when we're very poor. I thought, man, we're great at losing. It's almost a comforting place to be because when you don't have the money, you can budget. You figure it out. But what happens when you got a lead? When you're winning the game? What happens when you've started to make huge amounts of money? Are you starting to feel bad for the guy that's not making money? Does that cause you to give your money away, make bad decisions, buy marketing you shouldn't have bought? How is that affecting you that you can't go and finish your game and win your game? So I realized we're not that good at winning. It's a very uncomfortable place to be, is to be ahead. What happens is everyone starts voting and starts cheering for the underdog. No one's cheering for the guy winning after winning after winning. It's always funner to cheer for the underdog. Well, that's why I started thinking, man, this is crazy. Maybe this is why people struggle to get past that $100,000 mark in real estate, or even hit the $100,000 mark, let alone a half a million. Because once you hit that point, people aren't really your friends anymore. So all from playing squash, I realized, are you good at losing? Well, yes, we're all good at losing. We're phenomenal at budgeting money when we don't have any. But are you willing to push that extra mile? When you start getting ahead, are you willing to step in and finish the game? You step in and... So that day, I won four straight games. As soon as I realized, hey, I'm going to just win. I'm gonna do what I know what I need to do. I'm going to be okay with being the top guy. I'm not going to sabotage my life because other people aren't. Now, I'm going to win. Anyways, I just wanted to chat with you about this new realization. Are you great at losing, but are you good at winning? Are you good at being successful? Anyways, something to think about. Thanks for chatting with me, or I guess I was chatting by myself here. Anyways, talk to you later. Cheers.